As boxing promoter Don King, a bedazzled Don King, we should add, wearing quite a jacket, but using quite a word there as he's introducing Donald Trump at a rally in Ohio. He used the N-word. Back with us now, Angela Rye and Joseph Borelli. Angela, just your reaction.
So, first of all, my reaction is less about Don King because we know that Don King is outrageous, maybe almost as outrageous as John's candidate. What bothers me about this particular clip are I see three white men, including Donald Trump, laughing and smirking and smiling while he's making every comment about Negro and slips and says the N-word that I won't say on air. That is highly problematic to me for so many reasons. We were just talking about black outreach, and Donald Trump has to know, if he doesn't know anything else, because he thinks that we're in the worst conditions we've ever been in my community. He has to know that the N-word is not anything that we smirk and grimace about, particularly not in church. And so I don't know who decided that Don King would be the best person to intro him. But even still, this word is beyond the pale. And so for every amount of kudos I gave him just moments before about this police shooting and what he said that was calm and measured and actually the first balanced thing I've ever heard him say in situations like this, because normally he's calling us thugs, he's lost all of that with that smirk.
To Angela, what Angela's saying there, something you hear from other folks, is a criticism that Donald Trump is not really reaching out to African-American voters, not really reaching out to the black community. He's more, if you call it faux outreach, or he's more just reaching out to show moderate white voters that it's okay to vote for him.
Right. We can't fall into the trap of criticizing Donald Trump for not reaching out to African-American and African-American communities, and then when he does, actually saying that it's all fake, it's all a farce, without drawing some line and saying both cannot be true at the same time. But to this point,
they can't,
you know, clearly Don King's saying some type of a story where he's paraphrasing some story. Everyone in the background was sort of smiling. Maybe it was a comical story. I have no idea. But he slips and says the N-word. I
mean, no, but he says Negro. Negro is unacceptable in 2016, John.
Look, I'm sorry, I'm mad.
John's always acceptable.
You did not do it.
John's
a
great name.
John
but
is better,
look,
far better.
He's telling a story. He's speaking to an audience. He might be giving an example of what happened back in a worse era. I have no idea. We're taking it without.
He's talking about Michael Jackson.
We're taking this story without any context, and it was a clear slip of the tongue. He clearly didn't mean it.
So
he clearly corrected himself right after he said it.
That using Negro in 2016 is also unacceptable.
I mean, have you not listened to music where other African Americans use
language don't do that to me.
Far
Please don't
worse
do that
than
to me
this?
Today.
I mean, what I'm saying is Don King is saying a word that is suddenly now not acceptable.
What I'm saying to you is this trivializes your candidate's black outreach. I am going to tell you openly and honestly, and there will be people that are black, white, and everybody in between that won't like what I have to say. There are passes that black people get to use certain words. What I'm not going to give Donald Trump,
I'm about to finish. Okay.
Donald Trump is in the background smirking and grimacing while these comments are being made.
But you don't know the context.
I don't need the context. The N-word is unacceptable to smirk and grimace about when you're talking about doing black outreach. That is entirely the problem.
Yeah.
He doesn't have enough black friends who he can listen to on critical race theory issues to understand why his outreach.
And if he listed all his black friends, you'd say he's just listening to his black friends.
No, because I don't believe
that
he has any real black friends. That's why the woman from the Trump organization had to speak twice.
I don't know. His national press secretary has been an African American woman since the beginning of the campaign. I think he's always highlighted specific African American people.
Don King specifically, the RNC wouldn't let speak at the convention.
Great point.
Why bring out Don King when you're doing African American outreach? What does that say?
I don't know. I wasn't involved in that decision. Obviously, I don't know what the context even of the speech he's giving in, other than he's meeting with some members of an African-American community somewhere.
Horrible.
So I'm not going to speculate and then make a headline based on my own estimation. But obviously, he's trying to, you know, show something and show that he has support among some celebrity African-Americans.
Ignorance. And Don King, if they knew anything about just basic black outreach, you all, they would know that Don King is not a respected figure to use for black outreach. He is someone that is trivialized in the community. He is not respected in our community overwhelmingly. That is well known. So that further demonstrates my point that Donald Trump's black outreach people should go if he really wants to reach out to black voters.
Angela Rye, Councilman Joseph Borelli, interesting discussion.
Thanks
for being with us.
Thank you very, very much.